teapot set. It's kind of complex, so we wait for the end of the year and they have the skills to make this. There is three parts, actually four parts that have to all be constructed. My throwers have to throw their teapots. No one else has to throw. You don't have to unless you want to. Just a reminder, if you haven't thrown in a while, this is not teaching time. This is use your best construction skill for this. You can hand build whatever. This one is thrown. We threw the body, the spout, and the lid, and then hand built the handle. So here is another little one, also thrown. And then you have to make two more things to create the set. So it's really up to you what you want to make. You could make a creamer and a sugar. You could make two cups. You could make a cup and a saucer that it sits on. It's up to you. But I'm going to show you guys how to throw this. Oh, last thing. This is a teapot set, and it does have to have a theme. So you'll have to pick it out, and this theme is steampunk. So it's got like a little door over on this one and a little furnace here. Could be you want to go with steampunk. It could be you want to go with flowers. I don't know. There's so many teapots out there. Take a look. We're going to get on our phones when we get back and take a look. So our last project of the year is a teapot. So I'm going to demo a teapot. Here's a big one that I made, steampunk style. You do not have to throw this pot, but a lot of people hop back on the wheel and want to throw their pot. They think a teapot has to be thrown. Does not. So it has a lid that's thrown. It has obviously the body that's thrown, but also the spout is thrown. So I'm going to throw all three parts. That'll be part one. And then in part two, we'll put it all together. Here's a mini one I made that I made and I sgraffitoed on. So you can use any technique that you've learned for decorating this year. So again, thrown spout, thrown lid, and thrown little pot. All right. So the project requires three pieces. A teapot, a working teapot. The spout has to work. And then two more things. So teapots are kind of complicated. They are something you do at the end of learning. You've got a lot of slipping and scoring. You've got many parts that have to come together. But a lot of people make teapots. So that's going to be 35 points. And then you got to make two more things, 10 points a piece. Could be you make a cup and a saucer. Could be you make a creamer and a sugar bowl. Could be you make a tray and a cup. I don't really care. But it has to go together with a working theme. Now I've shown the throwers how to throw lidded pots, so they already know how to do this, but not everybody else. Base can be many shapes. It's a lot like a large cup. You can make it whatever shape you want. Be tall and thin. What I'm going to do right now is split the top. So I don't know if you want to come closer. And I'm going to make what is called a gallery or a galley. Depends on who you talk to. So I thicken this top up, and I'm gonna take either my thumb, or you can take the corner on this thing, and I'm gonna be pushing down and creating a lid that fits inside on an edge. This area is called the galley or the gallery. And then this area holds the lid from falling off so it doesn't fall. So we make this area kind of thick and then we push down. If you have a good fingernail, which I don't. So you could take something that is like a corner right here. I'm sort of supporting underneath. And I'm creating that gallery. I don't want it to be sharp. I'm gonna throw it just a little bit more. I usually put the gallery in on the second pull, maybe on the first pull. And then I pull one more time, one or two. But I need it to be strong enough to not collapse when I push down on it. So I'm gonna feel it one more time. I think I'm done. Now the gallery either is straight up or slanted slightly out. If you bend it, if you bend this part inward like that, the lid will be loose inside once it fits down in this smaller hole. So you need to keep it up straight or out just a little bit. I think I'm gonna put a little decoration on the outside with some slip. It's a little bit of texture. Now you guys have to do a theme on yours, so maybe you want it nice and smooth so that you can get your theme going on. Take the water out of the middle. And you always want to do that while it's spinning so that if you damage it, you can fix it. So, what I have to do next is I'm gonna throw my lid. And I always throw my lid on the same day I throw my pot because I don't want it to shrink on me. If you're running out of time, then you better take a measurement and write it down. And that way you can do it the next day. This is called the Lid Master, and it basically measures two things at once. I'm going to use this side up here to measure the inside from corner to corner on the inside. And then this side over here fits just the lid has to fit in between it. So you can see that lid fits pretty tight. So let's see where I am on this one. I don't want to damage it, so I'm going to not touch it. Okay, so I'm right in there, and that's pretty good. And that means my, this is my measurement inside the lid, and then this is what my lid needs to fit between. So I'm gonna throw my lid next with one of these small pieces right here. All right, so on a lid, we want like this one. We want the knob in the middle. We want a little space underneath the knob to be able to actually get our fingers underneath so we can pick it up. And then we're gonna create this outer edge. I'll show that to you. So this is centered. Instead of opening at center, like we normally do, we're gonna actually open about a third of the way out. When we do that, it just automatically creates a knob in the middle. So the first thing I do is I create my knob. So I'm going to bring it in a little bit. I'm going to go underneath. I don't want to cut it off, but I do want to have an underneath area. If it comes to, like, it looks like a cone, when you go to pick it up, if there's nothing underneath, you can't grab it once it's glazed, you just slip right off. So get that underneath area, You can make all sorts of different knobs. Some of my students are creating flat ones like that. You can make them come pointy. I tend to like a knob that has a little bit of a design on it. All right, so the knob is done. What I'm going to do next is I'm going to create a wall here. So I'm going to throw this outer edge. And I have a feeling it's going to be way bigger than I need. I don't want to get it too skinny. But I take my left hand here and I lay this down. I can leave it up, I can make it flat, or I can make it dip down. Okay. So, here's my measurement. I haven't moved it. And you can see I'm way too big. But that's just because I add extra clay. So, it's sometimes hard to make the clay get centered if it's a real small piece. So left hand underneath, stabilize, and I'm going to cut this off. Okay. I'm going to give a little bit of a sharper edge here. A little bit. I'll probably have to trim it. I'd rather have it too big than too small because I can trim away. So let's see where we're at now. We're just hitting, so that's pretty good. They're both thrown on the same day. That's good. Last but not least is the spout. And the spout is thrown actually all the way to the bat. Doesn't have to be perfect. It's probably more than I need. So I'm gonna open. I'm gonna go all the way down, and I'm gonna widen it. Up and in. So it feels pretty good down at the bottom. I'm going to concentrate on the middle and the top. So it's really thin right here, and I don't want it to get any thinner. This is going to be more than I need for a spout. I'm going to bring this in. And you throw more than you need. It's a lot like a handle, that you make the handle bigger than you need because you cut off the two ends and you use the best part in the middle. So I usually bring this down to quite small, smaller than I need. Sometimes I will even throw against my needle tool. So I'll stick my needle tool in here and I will close it off some more. My needle tool is just inside there pushing against since my fingers can't fit there anymore. So it doesn't have to be perfect. You're going to end up changing the shape of it. Some people will put a little design in it. And that's that. It's completely loose right now. Sometimes water comes out, but this is the one that will dry the fastest, so make sure you cover it. And that's it. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye. All right, that was it. We threw the three parts, and now if they're ready tomorrow, we're gonna put them all together. I'm gonna show you how to do that tomorrow with all the little tricky things that make a good teapot. So that's it. Come watch tomorrow.